है ना, so people don't have to scramble to write. I mean, you can always listen to it on the YouTube and everything. That would be great. Thank you so much for your participation and answering. Right. I think Abhishek wants to ask a question.
पहले आलोक जी पूछने आएंगे
तुम्हारा तो दिल मांगे मोर नहीं, दिल मांगे मोर 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 है
मोर टू द पावर मोर
या आई वाज सीकिंग परमिशन टू कैन आई गो अहेड
एंड प्लीज प्लीज आई एम सॉरी आई डिडंट सी हुज
या नो नो प्रॉब्लम
आलोक जी आलोक आलोक जैन
ओके सॉरी आई डिडंट सी दैट प्लीज गो अहेड आलोक
ओके सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज मोर टू विशाल जी And I was actually inspired by your discipline of, you know, going to temple every day and getting a benefit out of it. It's not more about the going to temple. It's more about the discipline. So when I do the meditation, I got some wonderful thoughts during the meditation. I write them down also, but over a period of time, it just fade away in the wind because the discipline is not there. So what's the best way, you know, you can put all your good thoughts and good intention into a real discipline so that over a long period of time you get the real benefit out of it? That's my question to Vishal.
So no, thank you so much for your kind words. So to see in my case, jo humara bolte hain sayam, and I really believe that power of niyam, and anyway, and I'm blessed actually, I feel like, because maybe it's that and made in, see, we all make promises to ourselves at the year end. Typically we make resolutions ki I'll do this and this this year, and we break. Maybe it's taking a niyam is more formal process, and in my case, because I did that, it gave me a lot of confidence to decide other things, not just going to mandir, but other niyams I took over the years. So that's just to putting it to a disciplined way. I do take niyam, for example, if I have to spend time with my kids, so I do take a minimum I need to spend this much time on a daily basis, right? So I have to force myself, otherwise it was going to let's say sometimes imbalance. So I resorted to that, and I think maybe that's one way to do it. I think other thing is that when you're talking to yourself every day, even for 10 minutes, when you're reflecting, eventually you will be having your own journey of evolution, right? Because then it is not your bosses giving you feedback, you're giving feedback to yourself. Then your year-end goals are not year-end goals. Once a month or once a year, you take them, or you're looking at them more regularly. So I think it makes you more reflective. It makes you talking to yourself on a daily basis. I think that way it really helps a lot. One thing I do see that often, first of all, one should not really crave for those thoughts during meditation. Otherwise, this becomes like another kriya, right? You are doing nothing, but you're thinking about the office matters. But I do get those thoughts. I do write them down then and there. And some of them are very pristine ones. So I do really make sure that I pay a good weightage to those thoughts and do execute them. So I do really take my notes on Evernote after the meditation, and they fade away very quickly as well. But I just want to tell everyone that meditation is not about, hey, you get powerful thoughts, or you get very mesmerizing experience. Sometimes it is just the chatter going still, as Prashant Bhai also mentioned. Your internal chatter is so strong, it keeps on going. But at the least it does is that I know that I'm doing meditation without expecting much in outcome. So at least it is helping me to be more equanimous, right? To be really not to be attached to the outcome. So it is like a practice. To me, it's a technique, right? And that's what I think has been my journey. I hope I answered your question.
Yeah, you did actually. Just one follow-up question on this niyam thing. So is it the way we take our niyam in Jainism, or is it something else for you?
I do that as we do in Jainism, but whichever way I think one does it, right, is fine. And I truly believe in that, giving me a lot of a toolkit, right? A powerful toolkit. So I do take, for example, I do not eat after sunset except once a week. So that's a niyam, as an example. Meditation is a niyam. Spending time with kids is a niyam. Some days it was like a 5 o'clock in the morning I took a niyam, but now I changed that given my new job and all. So anyway, but the best thing is that other thing I tell you, that because your kids watch you very closely, and I tell you that's a very personal experience, because my kids have known me that 12 baje agar raat ko dhyan aaya mandir nahi gaye, papa will go out irrespective. So my daughter, whenever she gets a lot of scolding ki hindi nahi ki ya unhe kya, to she takes a niyam. She takes a niyam for once a week, so for a week or 2 weeks. But it's very beautiful to see a young child of 11 years old take those niyams, and she's getting that toolkit herself, right? So what I'm telling you is that the benefit, right, are immense, because even best way to inspire our kids is by we following something. So that's what I've seen in my own personal life as well.
Okay, thank you very much. And the gist I got out of it is I need to find my own way of, having a in whichever possible way, whether it is niyam or some other way, find a way which can help me stick to those disciplines which I want to pursue. Thank you very much for all the answers.
Thank you, Alok Jain. So we've got Abhishek, and after that, Kunal. Yes, Abhishek.
So, first of all, thanks to everybody for such a mesmerizing session. So it is like, instead of asking too many, like a lot of questions going inside itself, right? So, but one thought which is coming to my mind is that at any means, again, connecting with the... Sometimes we think that we have to set our long-term goal. Where do we want to be? Probably 20 years down the line, blah, blah, blah. And there are two kind of thoughts come. One is a more of a materialistic thing. One is like, okay, giving back to society, societization. How can that this spirituality help you set the right goal? Because most of the time in an early age of our career, we always say, "Acha, mereko to manager banna hai, mereko ye banna hai, mereko ye banna hai." Those goal setting in the true sense, in the spirituality sense, can you guys help? Like, I'm at times directionless on that part.
Maybe I can attempt and then others can add. You know, what I have followed is a four quadrant matrix, and if it might help. And in the four quadrants, the first quadrant on the right is me, where I write down two or three goals that will only give me benefit, nobody else, not my family, not my wife, anybody else. For example, yoga, reading a book, meditation, puja, philosophy, running, meditation. It is only me, which I think I will like to do, or my personal hobby, collecting stamps or music, whatever that just gives me fun. Write 2-3 goals for I and say, these are my I goals. The second quadrant on the right below is the quadrant of the family, to say, what is it that I want to do with my family, extended family, and 2-3 goals that I can write down for my extended family. I will probably make sure I am with Diwali together, or I have lunch together, or I spend quality vacation together in one space, adventure trip or hiking trip once or twice or thrice a year. That would be the second quadrant on the right. The third quadrant, which is on the left bottom, I write down career and finance goals. And these career and finance goals are the goals that will empower me to fulfill all my other objectives. These goals in career and finance, I write down the career goals are functional and technical and soft skills I need to upgrade myself. That is my goals, that I need to become a better person, upgrade my skills, functional, technical, soft skills. That is one aspect to it. And the second aspect of my career and finance goals is the goals that I want to achieve in my career progression. What is it that I want to do next? 2 or 3 goals that will help me get there. The last goal on the left top is giving back to community, giving back to society, giving back to the nation, environment. And I write down 2 or 3 goals. I am a deep introvert by nature. And 20 years ago, I was not social. I was not going with my parents to any social event, etc. And today, if I would not have written these goals down, I don't think I would have been able to even be on this panel today. So personally, I've seen this does benefit. You become a complete man, or a complete person, fulfilling all aspects of life that you can, think about. So this is one which helps develop all the dimensions of holistically of a person. That's my experience.
And, I would also like to add to this what just Prashantji said. I think, and this is a very basic debate between, does being spiritual mean that you're not spiritual, you're not materialistic, or being spiritually inclined, does it mean that you're logon ko ye dar lagta hai ki yaar agar hum spiritual ho gaye to shayad ambitions kam ho jayenge, and we'll not be able to achieve what we want to achieve in life. You know, that's the risk which we all kind of have gone through, right? But, you know, my kind of conclusion on this matter, and obviously, you know, I believe that, you know, one is always in a constant phase of learning, is basically being spiritually inclined only makes your materialistic pursuits more meaningful, righteous, and holistic, right? तो अब जैसे एम्बिशन क्या होता है, हमारा एम्बिशन होता है कि हमें घर चाहिए, राइट? लेकिन कितना बड़ा घर चाहिए? यू नो 2000 स्क्वायर फीट का घर चाहिए, 5000 स्क्वायर फीट का घर चाहिए, राइट? तो वहां पे आपकी स्पिरिचुअल इंटेलिजेंस काम आएगी कि नहीं यार, मतलब 5000 स्क्वायर फीट का घर जरूरी नहीं है, आई नीड अ 2000 स्क्वायर फीट हाउस विच इज गुड इनफ फॉर मी. सिमिलरली मुझे गाड़ी यू नो होंडा सिटी चाहिए या मुझे BMW चाहिए या यू नो फ्रेंकली आई वॉन्ट टू ओन अ जगुआर एट सम स्टेज, राइट? So obviously, you know, the cost of materialistic pursuits, you know, is quite invisible, right? And this cost could be in form of your health, in form of your relationships, etc., etc. And that's where, again, spiritual intelligence comes into play and tells you, yaar, itna karne ki na zarurat nahi hai, right? I would rather be more happy with a Honda City with a driver than a Jaguar which I'm driving myself, right? So, you know, ye sab perspectives apne aap develop ho jate hain, and as Prashant ji said, right, at the end of the day, whatever we are doing is for holistic happiness, and it just does not come, you know, merely by chasing materialistic pursuits. Aapko apne aap ye lagne lagega, Abhishek, over a period of time, that my materialistic success is a byproduct. Main wo chase nahi kar raha hu, but wo automatically ho rahi hai, right? You know, I'm sure Vishal ji, you know, just became an MD with Accenture, right? Now, frankly, that has not changed the way he is at his core, right? Wo core mein jo pichle 15 saal se 20 saal se practices follow kar rahe hain, wo abhi bhi kar rahe hain. But materialistic success is just happening as a byproduct because he is just becoming a better version of his own self.
Thank you. Thank you. And thank you, Abhishek, for that question. And you were saying, you know, okay, Kunal, would you like to ask your question?
Yes. Hello everyone, Jai Jinendra, and firstly thank you to everyone, like whole JPF committee. It was really a great session. My question is to Vishal sir, like even I am working with Accenture from last 2 years now. I've done my graduation in from computer engineering. So like my main question is regarding consistency. Like whenever we try to do something new or we try to learn something new, the main concern is about consistency. Like we is there any spiritual way to be a consistent in learning something new or do something like if I consider my AWS certification, so learning that going through all the course, I'm not able to be consistent in that particular, like learning something new. So question is about consistency.
Nahi, thank you. And that's what happens typically. See, when we go to gym, we get a measurement. आज कितनी कैलोरी बर्न हुई, राइट? व्हेन वी डू सम कोर्स वी नो एग्जैक्टली ये आउटकम है. नाउ व्हेन यू सिट फॉर 10 मिनट्स, आप एक हफ्ते दो हफ्ते कर लोगे बिकॉज दिस सेशन हैपेंड, देन यू विल सी कि यार क्या फायदा, मतलब मैं खाली बैठा हूँ, ये क्या हो रहा है, राइट? मतलब सो दैट्स वेयर आई थिंक दिस इज नॉट लाइक अ फास्ट फूड आइटम वे यू डायरेक्टली ईट एंड गेट इंस्टेंट ग्रेटिफिकेशन. It does mean that eventually when you try to follow, you start seeing the results. You still see the results, but I would say that give it some time. What has happened in the name of meditation, what has happened is a lot of the way we have music on Spotify, likewise you have music for meditation. So that is solving for just peace of mind, mental calmness, sleep. These are very superficial things, right? And then people follow that. And then after that, everything becomes a routine. Even if you're listening to the best of the music, it becomes a routine. And then you lose interest. Then you keep looking for another entertainment. So that is not meditation. That is not really spirituality about. So I would recommend that, first of all, even if let's say it's 6 months or a year, 10 minutes, just set aside ki yaar 10 minutes mein mujhe bother nahi karna hai ki maine kya kya nahi kya. I want to just devote 10 minutes a day, right? And I do recommend follow some practice, because you do need to really have a formal at least way to do things, because there's a right way to do rather than just listening to a music or a shloka or a mantra, be it Aram Yoga, be it Bhavana Yoga, which I follow, or be it anything, right? But do follow that. Don't treat it as a fast food. But the risk is that people try so much. There's a Calm app, right? Calm.com app, which is very popular. There's Mindspace. In India, there are many apps out there. What happens in that case is that people follow and they lose interest very, very quickly. And after that, they always fear that ki koi chalta nahi, work nahi karta hai, because it becomes rather more damaging. I did Vipassana. Vipassana was 10 days course. That was my beginning. 10 days without any digital, without any TV, without even talking. It was totally cut off. It was very hard. But by doing that 10 days training, it really got me to the practice in the right way, actually. Otherwise, there would have been every chance to leave it in between. That's just my reflection. But there are different techniques, different ones. So I do recommend, make a promise that for this 10 minutes, I'll not bother myself. Ki iska kya hua, kya measurement hai. Give yourself some more time than a fast food typical behavior. And follow our practice, right? Whichever practice you follow, like Arum Yoga, for example, Prashandeya is overall leading that big one across India. So that's a very nice one as well. Follow something which can really keep you in the practice in the right way.
Right. Yeah, got it.
Sushma, can I just add?
Sure, please.
A couple of things just to build on what has been said. There are a couple of questions that you need to ask yourself. And one question is, why is it important to me? The other question is, what kind of person you want to become? And see if you can link it to that. Because until and unless you have a purpose, it will be very hard for you to continue or to make any new habit. So having a reason why you're doing it, and as Prashantji said, is it on the quadrant of I? Is it in the quadrant of, you know, my finance, my career, my family, to my society? Which quadrant does it really belong to? Is that important? So it will require a lot of self-reflection. It's not something which you can find on Google. You will have to look inward, but you will get the answer. And once when you get the answer, you won't need an alarm clock to get up. You will get up by yourself. Okay, Kunal.
Yes, rightly said.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Let's take this as a last question right now. And we really appreciate the time of everyone here. It's from Rishika Jain. Rishika, if you're there, I think what you're asking is you don't want to clear just SSC, you want to do UPSC. And trying to clear UPSC is making you materialistic. Or is it not making you materialistic? If you'd like to just come on, at least voice, it would help. Yeah, Rishika, please unmute yourself.
Ma'am, as sir said, he want more becoming materialistic. So that's my question. Ki if I want to clear UPSC, let me make me materialistic.
Okay, so I think the question is, if I want to clear UPSC, is it making me more materialistic?
Ji.
Right?
Yes,
ma'am. I would suggest, if you think about why you want to do a UPSC, is it because I want to do good for me, I want to do good for the government and do good for the society? By being a UPSC, by clearing UPSC, you might get a job which will help you become strong, have an influence and power to do good to the society. So with the right set of values, if you're pursuing UPSC, you're creating a good society that can be an inspiration to you with good values to do UPSC. It will not be a materialistic goal. But if you do UPSC with a materialistic goal, ki baith ke seat pe paise khaunga, that will make it materialistic. But if you do it with the right sense of values that I want to do good for me, win, win, win. Good for me, good for UPSC, the job, which is for the business, and good for the society. And I think I would strongly encourage har jain bacche ko UPSC IAS clear karna chahiye, or they should really get to position of power and influence, because normally all of us have good sense of values. Yes. And if you are not going to create that good value and a good society, don't expect somebody else will come and create that for you. So in my view, there is nothing materialistic about it. It is about getting the right belief. What do I really want to do? तो वो सवाल अपने से पूछना है कि what do I really want to do? And if you think by SSC करके ही मैं I can do good for the society, then you have to think how you will do it. So I think UPSC will enable you to do it. SSC is just one step.
That's but right. Yes, sir. Thank you so much. So thank you, sir.
Thank you, Rishika. And you know, all the best for your UPSC.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Right. And I think on that note, we should just end here. Would you like to share any closing remarks, one sentence? Prashantji, one sentence.
I need energy as well from you all. So I think it is in spiritual intelligence, it's also about seeking the energy from within, sharing it, and it's a circle of light comebacks to you. So I think it's if we create that society around us, the vibes I might give out today might come back and help me tomorrow. It is not my selfish interest, but my experience that if I associate with Vishal, I learn a lot from him and I get that energy from him. I share that energy hopefully with him. And therefore, you know, the more you start doing this, the more you create your environment, which you can control or not control, but at least you choose to be in. So the best way to get out of politics is to get associated with people who have the similar mindset and help and develop and learn from each other. So really happy to be here. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your time. Vishalji, Amitji.
So I would say feed your mind with powerful thoughts on a daily basis. That will be my takeaway. I think daily is critical. And set aside 10 minutes. Don't push yourself very hard that kya hua nahi hua. But set aside doing a particular practice with the powerful thoughts, with pious thoughts. I think that will change in the professional context. I'm not just saying in the spiritual context, even in the professional context, that will help you a lot.
Professional as well as family context, ma'am.
That's right.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. Amitji, over to you.
You know, firstly, I think right from the day I was asked to be a part of this session, you know, I can't tell you how enlightening that journey has been for me because, you know, I was forced to kind of, you know, think about the topic myself, right? And one of my bosses told me, communication is not what is said, it is what is understood, right? Mm-hmm. So, firstly, yeah. So, you know, you can say a lot of things about SI, but, you know, unless and until the listeners actually connect with what is being said and they, you know, they are really able to imbibe that, frankly, I would have said that I would have failed in either my own knowledge of SI or frankly, you know, what I have been reading about it over the years and more particularly over the last, you know, couple of weeks, right? So I must thank, you know, firstly, JPF and secondly, both Prashantji and Vishalji, because, you know, had they not suggested my name to this session, I think I would have not been a part of it. And frankly, I don't know about the 100 odd participants which we have on this call, but I have truly benefited, you know, from this session. And that's the power of giving, right? You don't know what you get in return, but frankly, you know, really, really thankful to all everyone here.
Absolutely. Couldn't agree with you more. I mean, it has been an honor for me, you know, to actually be part of this session and to be part of this mentoring program. Every time I learn a lot. So my request to everyone, have a great day. Please reflect on it. As Vishal says, please make it a daily habit. And the three W's that Prashantji talks about, you know, win for me, win for people around me, and win for society. The three W's, I think, are the huge takeaways for all of us. And of course, Dil Mange More, More, More. Come back in January. We'll continue meeting and continue doing things together. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all. Jai Janendra.